baseball fans, and welcome. The World Series on MLB The Show coming up. It's the Los Angeles Dodgers taking on the New York Yankees. With Chris Singleton, I'm John Ciambi. Plenty of storylines taking shape in this series as we set the stage for Game 4, Chris.
Well, the number one thing to discuss is just how lopsided this series has been. You know, you get to this point of the season, Boog, and you expect both teams to be on pretty even ground, but it's not played out that way at all. And when a team takes care of business with such dominance and gets out to a 3-0 lead, I just can't see this series lasting much longer.
Yeah, that's usually the way it goes, but hey, coming back to win the series has been done before. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. All right, first pitch coming up. And on the mound today, Luis Gil. What should we keep an eye on here?
Really labored his last time out. 4+ innings, wasn't able to qualify for the win, but fortunately got a no decision and didn't take a loss. We'll see if he can get in the W column today.
All right, ready to get underway. Here's Shohei Ohtani. Hit hard, should be extra bases. Around first, heading for two. And he's got a leadoff double.
Everything came together for him. Just a great approach. Looked like that was exactly what he wanted to do with that pitch. And right off the bat, he knew he was taking that wide turn at first to head for second.
Now it's Mookie Betts. Man at second. On the ground to short. Mookie zips it across. One out in the top of the first. Time to check out the Dodgers lineup. All right, Singy, how about all the talent in this lineup?
They're deep, first and foremost, but the way that they can manipulate their personnel for matchups and everything else, it's very intelligent the way that they use their team. And I think it creates a little bit of uncertainty for opposing teams, especially in a big game, big series.
Here comes Freddie Freeman up to hit. That one hammered, but pulled foul. One, two.
Two and two.
Squirts away a little bit. Well done behind the dish. One out and a runner at second here in Game 4 of the World Series. That both one out. Misses. Three balls, two strikes. There's a swing and a drive. Judge going back, and it's caught just in front of the wall. Runner tags and will move up to third. Cut off, now a throw home. It's offline. The run comes in, and it's 1-0.
We're expecting back and forth this entire game because of how good the offenses are.
And now it's Max Muncy. Two down, base is empty, but one run across here in Game 4. Swing and a miss as he was late one, that two. Time.
He didn't want to give up that run, but he did. Got the fly ball, sack fly out. Now it's time to attack these other guys. Get your team back in the dugout.
And he deals. And another ball.
I think it's huge that they were able to score right away. You're playing on the road. Stakes are high. Energy in the ball.
Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees. So it's one run, one hit, no errors, and no one left. Bottom half of inning number one coming up. It's the Dodgers 1 and the Yankees coming to bat. Back here with my pal Singy and our pitcher in this game, Landon Knack. What do we have on him?
Four-pitch guy. He's got some options to work with in terms of keeping hitters off balance. So we'll see how he decides to utilize those weapons through this start here. And whether or not he's able to mix them all in early or if he wants to hold something back a little bit later, maybe second, third time through the order, and give them something they haven't seen. It's tough when you know a guy's got that in his back pocket. As a hitter, you really have to stay on your toes. Talk about tying a guy up. That was ugly.
That misses the zone, and the count is 2-2.
It's a good take.
Got him looking, and he didn't like the call.
Frustrating end to the at-bat for the hitter, and I'm sure that's going to sit on him for a little while. You want to be ready to hit the fastball. Sometimes you can overthink things, and I think that was the case right there.
Swing and a miss. Nice changeup.
One ball, two strikes.
Good zip on that fastball at the bottom of the zone. If he's there all day, it's going to be a tough one for the hitters.
Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
Well, anytime you can punch out the top two guys in a lineup to start an inning, got to be feeling pretty good out there on the mound, because when you think of just having a distraction, table setters on the base paths, and all of a sudden you're dealing with the number three hitter, any distraction can cause you to serve up a cookie, and instead of it being a solo shot, it's a two- or three-run homer.
The 1-2. And that's a base hit into left field. So a two-out knock keeps the inning alive.
He was all over that one. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
And now it's Giancarlo Stanton. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Judge leads off first with two down to the inning. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. One left for the Yankees, and it remains 1-0. Top of the second, and now Teoscar Hernandez. And now it's 1-2. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. And a 1-2 again. And that's another ball. Chris, you and I have gotten to work some memorable postseason games together. One I look back on, 2013 ALCS Game 2, the David Ortiz Grand Slam.
Bogey just ran out of patience there. He took a couple of pitches to even that count up at two balls and two strikes, but that time chased outside the zone.
Now will be Will Smith. The wind and the pitch. And he swings through that one.
For me, Boo, the game I remember is us calling the 2014 AL wildcard game. The Kansas City Royals hosting the Oakland A's. The Royals come from behind to win in extra innings and move on to the division series. They had such a great run that it ended up in the World Series losing to the San Francisco Giants.
Torres over to first, and they get the out on Smith. Here's Kike Hernandez. Two outs, base is empty. Pitch misses there. 2-1. Swing and a miss, 98 on the gun.
Cold night tonight, Brugge. That's a pretty firm fastball right there. I tell you what, memories of getting jammed, they are creeping into my mind right now.
This one smoked out to left. Verdugo settles under and makes the catch. And that is that. Dodgers down in order, but they're on top 1-0. Back at Yankee Stadium, here's the third baseman, Jazz Chisholm Jr.
Oh, boy, a lot has changed for this kid from the Bahamas. Jazz was signed by the Diamondbacks as a free agent for $200,000. 4 years later, he's traded to Miami and played for the Jacksonville Jumbo Shrimp before getting his call to the big leagues. He's a player on the rise.
Left-hand hitter waits. Pulled the string of the changeup.
Well, he's really dialed in, and this offense is going to have to do something to try to break that rhythm. Maybe it's squirt around the bond, step out of the box, agitate him a little bit, do something that just changes what's happening right now, because at this pace, it's going to be a long game, so you got to figure it out quickly.
And here is Anthony Rizzo. The 2-2.
Counts good.
The Dodgers leading by a run, bottom half of inning number two. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. Got him swinging for the strikeout. Gassed it right by him. Back-to-back strikeouts to start the frame, and that's now three in a row.
Yeah, he's really settling in and getting a feel for his pitches, throwing them where he wants to right now. So we'll see how long he can keep this streak going.
And next for New York, Anthony Volpe. And that one fouled off. Down on strikes he goes, and the Yanks go quietly.
Impeccable command in that one. Three batters, three strikeouts. That's electric stuff out there on the mound.
Here at New Yankee Stadium in the Bronx, out of the third inning, and at the plate for the Dodgers, Tommy Edmund. The pitch. And he drops it down the third baseline. Bare hand scoop on the money. Nice play.
Oh, that was pretty right there. Beautiful play with the bare hand.
And now it's Gavin Lux. And a pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. One down, base is empty. That one lifted to left. Verdugo ranging after it. He's got it. There's two away. Shohei Ohtani up to the dish.
All around, I think if you asked anyone in this organization who's the best hitter in the lineup, they would say him.
And another ball.
Looks like he's being a little cautious with him in this at bat after doubling the first time up. Doesn't want to make another mistake.
But why to kick the pitch? Foul ball there. Got him looking. And a nice inning of work there as he sets him down 1-2-3. Nothing doing for the Dodgers here, but they lead it 1-0. Back in New York, ready to go for the last half of the inning. And stepping in for the Yankees, Austin Wells. Kicks and deals. Up the middle, there's Hernandez handling the chance. Whips it to first. Leadoff hitter gone in the third.
Good slider inside right there. Batter fighting to get there. Just rolled over it. Got the ground ball.
Here's Alex Verdugo. Righty delivers. Up and in, and a count 2-1.
2-1.
Back And a pitch. Swing and a miss. Had him out front for the strikeout.
Just absolutely rolling on the mound. He's looking very much on his game in the early parts of this one, Boog. Fully on the attack with these hitters.
That's seven strikeouts already, so he's got a good pace going, no doubt. So the lineup flips over. Now it's the second baseman, Gleyber Torres. Two down, nobody on. Swings, throw it in, that's a strikeout. Nothing doing here this half. Three innings in the books here in game four. It's the Dodgers one and the Yankees nothing. Back in the Bronx, John Ciampi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Mookie Betts. Bounce to the right side. And he handles it himself for the out.
Oh, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Freddie Freeman up to the dish. And that's off the inside edge. And it's 2-1.
Two balls, one strike.
Swing and a miss. Nice changeup.
Benny really sells the changeup with that arm action.
Freeman hits it in the air. Verdugo calls it in, and there's 2-1. Now two outs, bases empty. Here's Max Muncy, that funky Muncy. Two down, nobody on. Top half of inning number four. That's a base hit. Well, maybe that will end up getting him going.
Yeah, he really simplified there. Kept his shoulders square to the plate and wasn't trying to overswing. I think that's the key for him to have success through the rest of this series.
Here's Teoscar Hernandez. This one in the air. Torres under it. And that'll do it. One left for L.A. They lead it 1-0. The fourth game of the World Series. At the plate, Juan Soto.
You know, Boog, as a 20-year-old, this guy hit two home runs in the World Series. And the only players younger than Soto to hit World Series home runs are Andrew Jones, Miguel Cabrera, and Mickey Mantle.
Freeman steps on the bag, one out in the bottom of the fourth.
The center field, number 99, Aaron.
Now it's Aaron Judge up to the plate.
Boog, this offense is fighting for their lives right now. They're not ready for this season to be over, so they need to dig deep and find a way to get something going. Anything will help.
Slice the other way. That's a base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Just so sound in his mechanics. Hits against the front side. And the hands just continue to carry through the middle of the field.
Here's Stanton now. Swing and a miss. Nice changeup.
Two balls, two strikes.
The pitch keeps the at bat going with a foul ball. That's down and in. Oh,
on this count. Runner, not known for his speed, but I think you got to put him in motion. Try to avoid a double play here, Bert.
Jazz Chisholm Jr. waiting to hit for the Yankees. Righty to the plate. And that's ball four.
He's making things difficult for himself right now out there in the battle. But, you know, his confidence should still be high enough to get out of this, but he's going to have to buckle down right here.
Jazz Chisholm Jr. now. Two on, one out. And now two and one.
Tough spot right here. A couple runners on. Two ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
Left-hand batter waits. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. Here comes the judge around third. Throw is offline, and he scores. We're tied at one.
Well, he comes through clutch with the RBI single. That was big. Once you get the ball by the pitcher, there's a lot of base hits up the middle, even on ground balls. So a nice job to use that big hole and get himself a hit.
Two on, one out. Anthony Rizzo steps to the plate. Line drive. He's got it.
Not fooled at all right there. He was clearly all over it. But sometimes you hit it too hard and right at someone. You're looking for one of those bloop hits to get a knock sometimes.
Now the batter down, Anthony Volpe. One run across in the frame so far. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. This one in the air, center field. Edmund flashes the leather on the running catch. So one run in the inning on this base hit. All even at one apiece. You're watching the World Series on the show. Back here in New York, ready now for the fifth inning. And up to the plate is Will Smith.
If you don't get ahead in the count, you can forget about having any success against him.
That one ran inside, almost got him.
You know, these Dodgers just lacking discipline at the plate in this ballgame. They've been chasing pitches outside the zone all game, and it's led to some frustrating moments. They've been fooled quite a bit today.
And that's in there at the knees for a strike. Just off the outside part of the plate.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Payoff pitch. Out to short. And it finds its way through for a hit. So a man on base to start the inning.
The bat out of the game.
Here's Kike Hernandez. Yeah, that's outside. Now two balls and a strike. Nobody out. Runner at first.
The two strikes may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
Just outside. 3-2 now. Tommy Edman waiting to bat for the Dodgers. Payoff pitch. That ball is foul, and the pressure is building.
The healthy cut. Tough pitch at 98, but a really good pass at the ball.
Battling here as he fouls it away. Good battle here. About to be the eighth pitch of the at-bat. On the ground to third. Nice stop to first. Nicely done for the out.
Cat-like reflexes on that one. Makes the dive. Has to get up. Clean exchange to throw a strike across the diamond. And what a tremendous play.
And here comes Tommy Edman. Next offering upstairs. And it's second. Into the outfield, base hit, coming home. He'll score and they take the lead. It's 2-1.
His confidence level is so high. Really nice job of coming through in a big spot.
Pretty tough for the infielders to do anything with that one. He pulled it hard into the outfield, and even when you keep it on the ground, it feels great when you hit a missile like that.
And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Check on the runner. Edmund back on a dive. Edmund at first, one gone. Now a chance for Gavin Lux.
Ball.
Safe at second, and that was not close.
Well, he picked over once just before the pitch to check on him, but that didn't seem to slow up his jump on the pitch at all. I think that guy's been studying some video. Awesome job to be prepared, got the timing down, and he gets into scoring position.
And the right-hander deals. Swings through that one out in front that time.
Really consistent release point. He's been able to pick up and down and have excellent command at both locations.
Swing and a miss, struck him out.
He's locked in at the plate when he's using the whole field. He was out in front there. Just needs to let the ball travel a little more, and his timing will be back on track. Good pitch for the strikeout.
Shohei Ohtani steps to the plate for the Dodgers. That one missed. Kicks and fires.
Ball.
Mookie Betts. Up next for the Dodgers. Man on second, two down. And he walked him.
I don't think he really wanted to pitch to him right there anyhow.
The batter, the right fielder.
Here's Mookie Betts. On the bases with one already in. We're at the top of the fifth. Good eye right there. Movement in the Yankees pen. Marcus Stroman getting loose out there for Aaron Boone. Number 98 also throwing. The 2-2. Knocks that one away and we'll do it again.
Well, he got challenged with a good fastball right there. Just couldn't catch up.
Two, two on the way. And another ball.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
First and second, two down. Swing and a chopper. Jazz tosses the first, and Betts is gone. That ends the inning and stops things from getting out of hand. But they pick up one run on the RBI single, and this is now a 2-1 ball. This is the World Series on the show. Bottom of the inning, and now the catcher comes up to hit. Austin Wells. A good start for the leadoff dime.
Well, that may end up being an at-bat we go back to later on when this game is over. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch, just shot it through the infield.
No outs, runner at first. Now it's going to be Alex Verdugo. Runner on the goal. Swings and sends a rocket to right. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one down.
Now back. Second baseman. Laser.
Back to the top of the lineup. Here's the second baseman, Gleyber Torres. And here it comes. In the air, out towards right center. Sizes this one up. He's got it. And there are two outs. And now it's Juan Soto.
Right fielder.
Oh, look out here. He's going to come up ready to swing in this situation.
The Yanks down by a run. Last half of inning number five. That misses the zone. And yeah, that's ball two. Wouldn't chase that time. Aaron Judge. The kind of bat that can make a big impact if they can keep it going here. Two outs. Ripped, but it curls foul.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
The kick, the 3-2. Drilled to right, way back there, and that is gone. Gigantic blast. And they throw a pair on the board. It's 3-2. That one just sounded different.
And might have been the loudest moment yet. Man, my ears are ringing. I can feel that swing from the booth. That one was a hanger, and pitchers typically don't get away with making a mistake like that. And right there, he made him pay.
Nobody on. Here is Aaron Judge. Outside. Two and one. And a pitch. Judge rips that one. And no one can get there. Around first and hustling for second. Safe. And that's his third hit. And here comes the Dodgers manager to the mound. Pitching change coming. Landon Knack. Departs. We'll be back in a minute with a new arm on the mound. On the mound now, number 78.
Still pretty early in the ball game, so this bullpen has some work to handle. Best case scenario might be if he can come in here and get several quick outs, kind of bridge the gap that starter left for him.
So, man aboard. Now here's Giancarlo Stanton. The 2-1. That one ripped. And that should be extra bases. Rounds third, headed for the plate. He'll score easily. It's 4-2. And that's a two-out double.
Picks himself up an RBI. And you can turn a ball around at 107 off the bat. It's going to make you feel really good inside. If he elevates that a little bit more, it's definitely out of here.
And in scoring position with two away. Jazz Chisholm Jr. the next to hit. The pitch.
That's the ball down.
Two outs and one in scoring position. Fouls one off. 2-2. Into center and a base hit. Around third. Fires it to the plate. He's safe.
Comes through with the RBI. You'll often hear the phrase short to it, long through it, and that's a great example of it right there. Got the barrel in the hitting zone early, squared it up with the well-timed swing, and came away with a beautiful line drive in the center field.
Runner at first with two away. Next to hit, Anthony Rizzo. Here goes the runner. They pitch
two
out.
One.
Go to second. Out there. And that ends the inning.
Well, trying to get into scoring position, but a great catch and throw to end the inning. That's the way to pick up the pitcher.
We're back, and they make a change to start the sixth. The new pitcher, Marcus Stroman.
Now, and this is an important part of this game. Tight score and still a lot of outs to get. So they're looking for a big outing of them right here to get some critical outs.
The pitch. And a foul ball left side.
This is a very important inning here. After scoring all those runs, you want your pitcher to come out and just mow them down. The offense has worked hard. It's shut down inning time.
That's ripped, and this one could be extra bases. Makes the turn and heads for second. And he greets the new arm from the bullpen with a double.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy, didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep, took the barrel right to it, and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit.
Muncy digs in. Outside, and that is ball four.
Well, he earned his trip to first right there. It's not easy laying off pitches that just missed the zone like that. And it's a real discipline as well. He's put a lot of work into that aspect of his game, and it paid off right there.
With the tying run at the plate, and we're the top half of the sixth.
That's the effect of the splitter that you're looking for on the mound. Really nice pitch right there, and had him out in front over the top. I'm sure the batter was thinking he was getting something else, perhaps a fastball a little more straight and velo to it.
Next up, the Dodgers catcher, Will Smith. Two on, one out. Right field, down the line, and that one slices foul. And this is inside. And there's a ball.
Full count.
Right-handed reliever fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. At the belt and fires, and that'll load the bases.
Well, the stage has been set for this offense, Boo. It's all about creating opportunities, and this is one of them right here.
Bases loaded with one away. Next to hit, Enrique Hernandez. Freeman at third. Muncy on second. Smith at first. One gone.
At the dish, looking to lift the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning double play, Boo.
And the righty deals. Got him swinging. It's a strikeout. Slider got him for strike three.
Well, that slider wasn't even close to the strike zone, and he got him to chase. That's just a bad approach right there. Either he was looking for something else and got completely fooled, or he was sitting all over the slider and just couldn't resist the temptation. But, man, really expanded right there and didn't have a chance of making contact with that pitch.
Tommy Edman at the plate. Fights it off. He'll see another. Two outs. Bases are full. Breaks his bat and pops it up.
And a foul ball.
Two outs. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Righty delivers. Strike three. Got him swinging. That's the third out. They leave them loaded. 6-7-8-2 in the bottom of the sixth. It's the Yankees 5 and the Dodgers 2. Back for more from the Bronx. And here's the first baseman, Anthony Rizzo. Here comes a pitch. And right back to the mound. Tosses to first. One away, bottom of the sixth.
The batter number 11. Shortstop, Anthony.
Anthony Volpe getting ready to hit. That missed by a lot. And that's ball two. The Dodgers bullpen with some action. Daniel Hudson looks to be getting ready for manager Dave Roberts. Brazier getting cranked up as well. One down, base is empty. Way out front for strike two.
2-2 is the count.
Misses, and now it's 3-2.
He missed the zone, but I don't think he missed his spot. That was a good pitch with two strikes.
Back to work, 3-2 now. Line drive, base hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count. Pretty much a model swing on that one as he ripped it into the opposite field gap. And I'm sure he's going to be watching that one back on video because that's the kind of swing you want to bottle. So many positives that led to that knock.
Nice grab.
Clearly stole a base hit right there. Excellent job. Great athleticism by the shortstop to make that leaping catch to bring it down. It was a line drive headed for the outfield.
So up next, Alex Verdugo. Left-hand hitter waits. Next pitch in for a strike, 1-2. Right-hander kicks, deals.
Down, ball.
And that's a stolen base, not even close.
Turned out to be a pretty good pitch to run on right there. Off-speed pitch down in the zone. That can be pretty tough for a catcher to reach down and grab it and then get rid of it quickly enough to prevent that would-be base stealer.
Ground ball up the middle. Lux throws the first in time. Third out. The Yanks leave one. They're still out in front 5-2. Back at Yankee Stadium, now it's the second baseman, Gavin Lux.
The second baseman, Gavin Lux.
That smash towards center. Corrals it, and there's one down.
Man, that's one of those at-bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it, but in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at-bat.
The pitch. And another ball.
Well, with both starters out of this ball game, it now becomes a battle of the bullpens and just seeing which manager can match up better and who's able to get to the finish line.
Swing, and this one's bounced to the ground. On to first, and two away to start the seventh.
Now, the right field. Mookie. Bet.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's Mookie to hit. The Dodgers trailing by three late here in game four. The 1-1 is fouled off. And a 1-2. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. Dodgers go down quietly. They trail at 5-2. Bottom of the seventh. Here's the Yankees leadoff hitter, Gleyber Torres.
Gleyber Torres.
And he deals. And a strike to Gleyber.
Threw that fastball right by him, slightly elevated. That's a confidence boost for this guy out there on the mound.
Oh, that ball drilled back up the box and nailed the pitcher. And they get the out after the ricochet. And now they'll hustle out to check on him. That was quite a shot he took as you see him down on the knee.
Yeah, clearly in some real pain, but he will not want to come out of this game if he doesn't have to. It's looking to me like he's going to try to shake it off and continue.
One down, base is empty.
No, that's out.
Base hit, that was smoked through the infield.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. Pulled that one right in the direction of the shifted defense, but no one could make a play on it. I mean, that's his approach, and it's probably not changing.
The 2-1. And a breaking ball drops in for a strike. Soto leads off first with one away. Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. He makes the catch, and there's two down.
Now back, the designated hitter, Giancarlo.
Man at first, Giancarlo Stanton stepping in now for the Yankees. Two outs. Bounced out to short. Hernandez tosses to first, and they take care of Stanton for the out. That's the inning. One left for the Yankees, and it remains 5-2. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Tim Mesa. And now the first baseman, Freddie Freeman. The Dodgers in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. I need a good at bat out of him right here.
Here's a 1-1. Got the back one too soon. It's strike two.
Got to keep things airtight defensively right here. On your toes, ready to make a play. If you can get this to the ninth with a three-run lead, it should be a W.
That one 95 to finish him off. Here's Muncy to hit. Swing and a miss. He was late. Strike two.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
And now the count is even.
That's a good miss off the inside part of the plate. You'd much rather miss there than out over the plate where this guy could do some real damage.
And a pitch. And delivers outside. Lefty continues to work, but the closer getting loose in the bullpen. Outside, and that is ball four.
His ability to draw walks has been something that's been part of his career since day one.
Man at first with one gone. Now the left fielder, Teoscar Hernandez. The lefty ready, and a 1-1.
Ball, that's
and that
down.
One missing low. And a 2-1 hammered, but foul. The Yankees leading by three, and we're at the top of the eighth. Up and in, counts full, 3-2. Struck him out looking.
Well, he's going to have some thinking to do when he leaves the ballpark after this one. That was his third strikeout, and this one looking, obviously. So he's been a little overmatched. He's got to find a way just to be more competitive up there at the plate.
Now Weaver comes out trying to close it out. Will Smith steps to the plate for the Dodgers. It's offered in there for a strike, and it's 1-2. Stays alive. Two outs. Bows it off, still 1-2.
I want to start that load a little bit sooner because of the good velo.
Here's a 1-2. And that's outside. Blasted it right past him. So the Dodgers leave one, and the deficit remains 5-2. Back at Yankee Stadium, ready for the bottom of the eighth. And stepping in for the Yankees, Jazz Chisholm Jr. Lined in the left center, base hit. Man, Siggy, he hit that ball right on the sweet spot. According to StatCast, the exit velo 110 miles an hour.
Yeah, Boog, I mean, that right there is an absolute missile. And he just put a great swing on it, squared it up perfectly. Those are the ones that feel really good.
Digging in, Anthony Rizzo.
Yeah.
Swing and a miss.
One ball, two strikes.
Just off the inside edge. Swings through it for the K. Couldn't catch up to the heater. Man at first, Anthony Volpe stepping in now for the Yankees. Yankees up by three. Here the bottom half of the eighth inning. On the ground, two ball. Lux. Feed to second. That's one. Double play. And that'll do it for the inning. No runs, one hit, no errors, and no one left. We're through eight full here in game four. It's the Yankees 5 and the Dodgers 2. Back in the Bronx, all set to start the ninth in this one. And the batter will be the shortstop, Kike Hernandez. And the pitch gets a piece and stays alive. Righty to the plate, outside low, now 2-2. Another ball. And a 3-2. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout. He's two outs away. And next for LA, Tommy Edman. The Yanks trying to close out a three-run lead here at the top of the ninth. The 1-1 is fouled off. One down, base is empty. Swings and misses, struck him out. Here's the second baseman, Gavin Lux. Weaver is just one strike away. Lifted to left, and that should do it. He's got it. Ball game. The Yankees stay alive. They take this must-win game four.
You never want to come into a postseason series and get swept. You want to feel like you've had a chance. You've worked so hard to get here. They've still got a long way to go, but after this win in game four, maybe, just maybe, they feel like they've got a chance.
Your final score, 5-2. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
Final line for tonight. First for the victorious Yankees. 5 runs on 11 hits. No errors. They left 7 runs on base.